Welcome to Travel Off the Grid channel. In this video we will be exploring one of the most significant architectural masterpieces of ancient times, the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus. This temple was one of the seven wonders of the ancient world and stood as a testament to the engineering and architectural skills of the ancient Greeks for over 400 years. Let's dive in and discover the fascinating history and mystery surrounding this ancient temple. The Temple of Artemis, also known as the Temple of Diana, was one of the most impressive architectural masterpieces of ancient times. Built in the 6th century BCE, it stood in the city of Ephesus, which was located in what is now modern-day Turkey. The temple was dedicated to the goddess Artemis, who was a major figure in ancient Greek religion and mythology. This temple was one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, and it was considered to be one of the most beautiful and grandiose architectural structures of its time. The temple was built entirely of marble, and it was adorned with intricate carvings and sculptures depicting the goddess Artemis and various scenes from Greek mythology. It was said that the temple was also covered with precious stones and other luxury materials. The temple was a major center of worship and pilgrimage for ancient Greeks, and it was also an important center of commerce. The temple was also a symbol of power, wealth and prestige for the city of Ephesus. The temple was burned down and destroyed several times by various invaders, the last time by the Goths in AD 262, and the ruins of the temple were rediscovered in the 18th century. The remains of the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus are an important archaeological site and are a testament to the skill and ingenuity of the ancient Greeks. They continue to fascinate and inspire people to this day, and are a must-see destination for anyone interested in ancient history and archaeology. The architecture and design of the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is truly awe-inspiring. The temple was built on a massive scale, measuring over 130 feet wide and over 400 feet long. The main hall of the temple, known as the cella, was surrounded by a double colonnade of marble columns that stood over 50 feet tall. These columns were intricately carved with scenes from Greek mythology, such as the hunt of the Caledonian boar, the labors of Hercules, and the Battle of the Amazons. The temple was built entirely of marble, which was quarried from the nearby island of Lesbos. The marble was then transported to Ephesus and used to construct the temple's walls, floors, and columns. The use of this high-quality material, along with the temple's impressive size and grandiose design, helped to make it one of the most iconic architectural structures of the ancient world. The temple's roof was also a sight to behold. It was said that the temple was covered with a wooden roof that was overlaid with gold and ivory plaques. The roof would have glistened in the sunlight, making it an even more impressive sight. The temple was also adorned with sculptures and statues of the goddess Artemis, as well as other figures from Greek mythology. These sculptures were made of marble and were incredibly detailed and lifelike. In addition to its grand architecture and stunning sculptures, the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus also featured several other architectural innovations. The temple was one of the first ancient buildings to be built with a terrace, which supported the weight of the temple and provided access to the upper levels of the temple. Additionally, the temple's cella was illuminated by a unique system of skylights that allowed light to filter into the interior of the temple. The Temple of Artemis at Ephesus was truly a marvel of ancient architecture and design, and it's no wonder that it was one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Today, the remains of the temple continue to fascinate and inspire visitors, and offer a glimpse into the incredible engineering and architectural skills of the ancient Greeks. The Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is steeped in myths and legends that add to its allure and mystery. One of the most prominent legends associated with the temple is the story of Artemis, the goddess for whom the temple was dedicated. In Greek mythology, Artemis was the daughter of Zeus and Leto, and the twin sister of Apollo. She was the goddess of the hunt, wilderness, childbirth, virginity, and protector of young girls. She was also considered as a goddess of fertility and childbirth. She was often depicted as a maiden carrying a bow and arrows, accompanied by hunting dogs. According to legend, the city of Ephesus was founded by the Amazons, a tribe of fierce female warriors. The Amazons believed that Artemis was the protector of their city and built the Temple of Artemis to honor her. The temple was said to be the center of worship for the Amazons and played an important role in the religious and cultural life of the city. Another legend tells the story of how the temple was built and destroyed multiple times. The first temple was said to have been built by the legendary architect Chersiphron and his son Metagenes. They were said to have used the latest architectural techniques and materials to construct the temple, which was considered to be one of the most beautiful and grandiose structures of its time. However, the temple was burned down by a madman named Herostratus, who wanted his name to be remembered forever. The temple was rebuilt, but it was burned down again and destroyed by various invaders, the last time by the Goths in AD 262. The myths and legends associated with the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus add to its mystique and make it an even more intriguing destination for those interested in ancient history and mythology. The stories of the goddess Artemis, the Amazons, and the temple's destruction all contribute to the rich cultural heritage of the temple, making it a must-see destination for anyone interested in ancient Greece and its religion. The eventual destruction and rediscovery of the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is a story of both tragedy and triumph. The temple, which was once one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, fell into ruin over the centuries. The temple was burned down and destroyed several times by various invaders, the last time by the Goths in AD 262. After the temple's destruction, the materials of the temple were reused in other buildings, and its ruins were covered by sediment and forgotten for centuries. The rediscovery of the temple's ruins in modern times is a fascinating story of persistence and determination. The first excavations of the site began in the late 18th century by a British explorer named John Turtle Wood. He found the first column of the temple in 1869, and it was later excavated by the British archaeologist John Turtle Wood. The German archaeologist Theodor Weygand continued the excavations in the early 20th century and revealed more of the temple's remains. The temple's rediscovery brought to light the incredible engineering and architectural skills of the ancient Greeks, and it also helped to shed light on the rich cultural heritage of the city of Ephesus. Today, the temple's ruins are a popular tourist destination, and the ongoing efforts to preserve and restore them have helped to bring the temple back to life in a sense. The temple's eventual destruction and rediscovery is a testament to the fragility and resilience of human civilization. The temple, which was once a symbol of power, wealth, and prestige, fell into ruin and was forgotten for centuries. But the rediscovery of its ruins in modern times has helped to remind us of the incredible achievements of our ancestors and the importance of preserving our cultural heritage for future generations. The current state of the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is a mix of both preservation and preservation efforts. The temple's remains have been excavated and restored over the years, but much of it still lies in ruins. The temple's remains consist of a large number of scattered marble columns, the foundation of the temple, and some of the sculptures and carvings that adorned the temple. Visitors can still see the grandeur and scale of the temple, and imagine how it would have looked like in its prime. The ongoing efforts to preserve and restore the temple's remains are both important and ongoing. The site is considered as an archaeological site and is protected by the Turkish government. The temple's remains are regularly monitored and maintained to ensure their preservation for future generations. Conservation work is carried out to prevent further deterioration of the remains and to stabilize the site. In addition to the preservation efforts, there are also efforts to reconstruct the temple in a digital format. The temple has been scanned and digitally reconstructed in a 3D model, which provides an interactive experience of the temple and allows visitors to explore the temple as it would have looked like in its prime. The current state of the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is a reminder of the rich cultural heritage of the ancient Greek civilization and the ongoing efforts to preserve it for future generations. It's an interesting and engaging topic for viewers, and it is a must-see destination for anyone interested in ancient history and archaeology. In conclusion, the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is a true marvel of ancient architecture and design. From its impressive size and grandiose design to the intricate carvings and sculptures that adorned its walls, the temple was a testament to the skill and ingenuity of the ancient Greeks. The temple's fascinating history, myths and legends, and the current state of its remains all contribute to its allure and make it an intriguing destination for those interested in ancient history and archaeology. The temple's eventual destruction and the rediscovery of its ruins in modern times is a story of both tragedy and triumph. The temple's remains have been excavated and restored over the years, but much of it still lies in ruins. The ongoing efforts to preserve and restore the temple's remains are both important and ongoing, and they help to remind us of the rich cultural heritage of the ancient Greek civilization and the importance of preserving it for future generations. The Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is not just an archaeological site but also a window to the past, giving us a glimpse of the incredible engineering and architectural skills of the ancient Greeks, the religious and cultural significance of the temple, the myths and legends associated with it, and the culture of the city of Ephesus. If you're interested in ancient history and archaeology, or simply want to discover the wonders of one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, then the Temple of Artemis at Ephesus is a must-see destination. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and share this video to spread the word about the incredible Temple of Artemis. And subscribe to my channel for more informative and engaging videos on ancient history and archaeology. Thanks for watching, please like and subscribe.